Call yourself a photo bomber?
Yeah.
Where did you learn that word?
You didn't know I knew that word?
No, I did not know you knew that word. How would I know that? Look, two birds. What are those?
Seagulls.
Seagulls. How was your blackberry soup?
Do you know what my favorite drink is?
What your favorite drink is? Westy. Let's enjoy the last bit of this sunset.
You mean the beginning?
No, this is not the beginning of the sunset. It's the end of the sunset.
It's working!
Oh yeah, the video is back on, isn't it?
I'm gonna move!
I know what you're doing. You're just trying to get in front of the camera. I don't want you in front of the camera. I want the sunset. Look.
What is it? What is it, Dad?
I don't know.
What?
Some sort of flying object. Hey, let's talk about something.
What?
Tell me, did you catch any crabs today?
Where?
Huh?
Where?
What do you mean where? At the beach.
Yeah, but we weren't. I wasn't with the kids.
How many crabs did you catch?
I don't know. Maybe like one or two.
One or two crabs?
Mm-hmm.
Big ones?
Yeah.
Little ones?
Yeah. I dig the trench and we made this huge island. It's like. From there, yeah, it's like, and you can sit on it, and water flows all around.
Oh, really?
So we made three islands today.
Three islands?
Yeah, but not like on the ocean, in our like trench.
You're like the nation state of Dubai. You know, in Dubai, they make artificial islands that are so big, people can build houses on.
Yeah. Like that.
Like what?
Like Lummi Island.
You think Lummi is an artificial island?
What does that mean?
Like made by man?
What about in Los Angeles, that huge island you
said? In Los Angeles? Oh, you mean in Long Beach?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Long Beach has some artificial islands too. Yeah, that's right.
Huge ones?
Yeah. Did you catch any other animals today? Or see any other animals?
Yeah. We were mostly working on it.
Mostly what?
Mostly working on the canal.
Uh-huh.
And tackling Leo and tackling Hank.
Tackling Leo and Hank.
Every time we washed our hands, except for one time, we went on Leo.
Well, Leo's awfully big. Isn't he like 14?
No, he's 13.
13.
I mean, he's awfully big.
He's awfully big for a 6-year-old to be a 10.
But we can still attack him if I have hope like Hank. I can tackle Hulk. Well, before he broke his arm.
I think his arm's better now.
Really?
Yeah.
It was like 12 years ago. I'm cold. I'm gonna go get a blanket.
You're gonna get a blanket?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll wait for you here. You're a strange giggling silhouette.
I want to see it.
You can't.
Why?
Because this video doesn't go backwards.
What?
This video doesn't go backwards.
Why?
I don't know. That's a flattering perspective.
What?
Wait, so when you said you wanted to go get a blanket, you were actually just tripping. Excuse me. Media whore, come here for a second.
Can we read Ladybug Girl and Bingo?
Ladybug Girl?
Yeah, right here.
Yeah, let's read it. This is where we should put the tent, says Lulu. She's excited to be camping.
That's Lulu. She's a little
girl. And to sleep in her new sleeping room. Isn't this fun, Bingo? We're going to sleep outside. But Bingo isn't standing by her side like he usually does. He's zigzagging all over the campsite, smelling everything. And suddenly Bingo stops. He puts his nose straight up in the air and bolts off toward the woods. Papa quickly grabs Bingo by his collar and snaps on a leash. We're in the wild, not our backyard, Lulu, says Papa. Make sure to hold on to Bingo's leash so he doesn't get lost. Don't worry, says Lulu confidently. Ladybug Girl would never let that happen. While her parents and her brother are unpacking and pitching the tent, Ladybug Girl and Bingo decide to explore around their campsite. The forest is filled with exciting discoveries. Ladybug Girl and Bingo cast spells with a gnarly old wizard, ride on a galloping giant turtle, and sip tea with the buttercup fairies in their secret garden. And then the whole family hikes to a nearby lake. Bingo is pulling so hard that the leash slips through Lulu's fingers. Lulu's brother snatches up the leash. I'll hold him, he says. You're gonna let him get away. No, I won't, says Lulu, taking the leash back from her brother. And when they finally arrive at the lake, they rent a canoe. Everyone has to wear a life jacket, even Bingo. Lulu thinks
that... Actually, you never have to wear a life jacket.
What? What? Lulu thinks that Bingo looks like a brave sea captain. That's pretty cool. The canoe glides onto the water. Lulu loves the feeling of floating along. And when they get into the middle of the lake, her parents stop using the oars and they drift. It's so quiet that Lulu can hear the clouds moving. It's peaceful. And she doesn't have to worry about Bingo running off here. Lulu looks over the side of the canoe. Look, she yells, I can see an underwater castle and mermaids. That's just weeds, says her brother. Lulu looks again. No, it's definitely a castle for mermaids. And probably merm dogs, too. Maybe her brother needs glasses. After they return to their canoe, it's time for picnic lunch. Lulu eats a giant cheese and tomato sandwich, and at least 38 blueberries. Bingo has two birds. Kibble, everything tastes better outside, thinks Lulu. When they finish lunch, Lulu jumps up and asks, do you want to play, Bingo? And he pulls her toward the forest. We could play Explorers of the Jungle. How we're trying to find a lost unicorn, and we have to watch out for tigers. You stand right here, Bingo, Lulu says, looking, hooking the leash over a branch. And I'll climb up this tree and see if I can find a unicorn. Crack. Lulu hears the snap of a branch, and before she can blink, Bingo is racing away with the leash trailing behind him.
Fox.
No,
look,
Bingo.
There's a fox.
Oh my goodness. She yells as loud as she can. Come back. Oh no, Lulu cries. Where did Bingo run off to? What if I can't find him? What if he's gone forever? No, Ladybug Girl says out loud. She knows she will find him even if she has to look under every leaf in the forest. Ladybug Girl blasts off like a rocket to search for Bingo. She whizzes through a maze of trees, not caring if her wings get snagged on the branches. Bingo, she calls, but he doesn't come. And after she leaps over a rushing river and stops beside a humongous boulder, she hears a familiar snuffling sound. Ladybug Girl zooms to the other side, and there, rooting in circles around a pine tree, is Bingo. There you are, Bingo, she says, flipping her arms around him. I'm so glad I found you.
There's a fox, I told you.
Ladybug Girl stands up and says, let's go back now. And she looks around and she realizes that she isn't sure how to get to their campsite. She ran so far that Bingo and her could be hundreds of miles away. What if they needed a helicopter to bring them back? Bingo tries to climb up the big rock. Up here? Asks Ladybug Girl. Holding Bingo's leash extra tight, she climbs to the top of the boulder, and from this high up, she can see the entire forest. She sees the old wizard tree, and then looking down, she realizes that she is standing on a giant turtle rock. Ladybug Girl can even see her tent. Ladybug Girl and Bingo run breathlessly back to the campsite. Mama, Papa, guess what? We were searching for a lost unicorn, but then Bingo escaped into the woods and I chased after him forever. And then when I found him, we were both lost in the woods, but then Bingo helped me figure out where we were and we made it back all by ourselves.
You weren't lost, said her brother. You were right over there. We could see your wings the whole time.
Ladybug Girl looks in the direction of where they came from. It's really very far away. Maybe her brother doesn't need glasses after all. Later, after dinner, they toast marshmallows around the fire. Can you believe we're up so late, Bingo? Lulu asks, staring at the stars that cover the whole sky.
Wow, there are even stars in the trees, Lulu says.
Those aren't stars, her brother says. They're fireflies.
Fireflies?
You should like them, he says. They're bugs that light up. When it's time to go to sleep, Ladybug Girl wriggles into a new sleeping bag with Bingo.
I love you, Bingo, Lulu whispers.
It's been a long day and Ladybug Girl is a little bit sleepy, but tonight, Firefly Girl is up. Are you ready for bed, little buddy?
It is 9:30 p.m.
You know, it's time to go to sleep.
Look, the train's coming. The train's coming.
Okay. Good night. Let's go. Come on.
There are like 5 minutes.
Good night, sweet Gishers. okay, guys, nighty night.